Welcome back to the show, everyone. Always a pleasure to see our next guest. And we are talking about happy hockey things today, including Go Jets Go.
Yes, Rob Feeney is joining us. Of course, food concept architect from Cactus Club Cafe. How are you?
I'm doing great. Fantastic.
How was the game?
Part-time Winnipegger now, right?
Part-time Winnipegger, yes.
And, Go Jets.
Well, you know, it's funny. I was saying earlier, I wore my Jets jersey t-shirt to the UFC fights last week. Got a lot of high fives on it. But yeah, hey, listen, it's exciting for the city. It really is. It's really and for Canada too. I mean, how often does a franchise lose and then come back again?
I think it's amazing.
I think it's great for
now.
Canadian
Father's
hockey.
Day is Sunday.
Yes.
And we are doing a little Father's Day thing today. What are we doing?
Well, you know what? Having said that, it's fathers, and there's a lot of new fathers on the Canucks. So let's like look at the positive side,
right? Mate.
And so I wish them all the best this Father's Day. And I was thinking about them because I know those guys eat a lot of steak on the road.
They do.
Right. So what father does want steak? Right?
Every dad
I'm a father,
I know.
And if you're watching, honey, I want steak this Sunday.
So vegan fathers,
how are
but we don't
going
talk about
to
them.
This is a beautiful steak.
Yeah,
what cut?
This is a porterhouse steak, so we got a little bit of a tenderloin. We got a tenderloin here coming, and we got the cool thing about a porterhouse is that you've got a lot of marbling going on. It's like I was actually speaking of Canadian steaks. I mean, Canadian prime is probably the best meat in North America. And it's really well marbled. So, I mean, that's the cool thing about having
and
this kind of steak.
Marbling is flavor.
Marbling is flavor. I mean, it doesn't really happen so much in tenderloin. It can now and then.
Yeah.
But that's why this is a really good steak. It's got lots of flavor. It's on the bone and not that difficult to cook. And so what I've done with this is, and I mean, obviously right now with this kind of weather, you can barbecue. So you got your choice of doing this on the barbecue if you wish. Or on in your boiler in the oven, right? Either way, you can do it.
I mean, the barbecue.
All you really need to do is, and
no
this
dishes.
Is what I do. This is just simple.
No
this is just olive oil.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to do it. And then all they have to do is, this is a little bit of fleur de sel.
Just a touch.
Right? Yeah, that was just a touch. And then just some pepper. You can put as much pepper as you want. So you're going to do this both sides, right?
Right.
Yeah. Both sides, and then once that's done, you can, and don't do it too far in advance, because the salt will actually pull some of the liquid out of the steak.
And does the oil seal the flavor, or what do you do that for?
I just love olive oil, because it gives it and you can always brush more on as you're cooking.
A little richness to
it. So
this
way, we just keep it really natural, and because we're doing kind of a Florentine type of steak,
mm-hmm.
this is kind of what we want to do. So this is how I would sort of prepare it in advance,
okay.
And I'll show you how it's going to look when it's done. And in the meantime, what we're going to serve it with is on the end with Michael. We're going to do that's a little bit of we're going to finish this when we're ready to go. Not quite yet. Don't get too excited.
Back off.
You've got a little bit of red onion. There's some tomatoes, and in there we've got a little bit of honey, soy, balsamic, olive oil, and you're going to mix that together, and that's going to go on top of the steak.
Okay.
And then
that.
So I'm going to show
gotcha.
You. I'm going to make a little broccoli gratin because. You know, when you look at steakhouses and you look at all the different garnishes, this is something a bit different. So
this is
a
little bit of a party what you've got going on here.
It's a big time party with lots of all the things we need. Like, I mean, this is just steamed broccoli that's been steamed.
I won't take it for granted.
Okay. And then we're gonna take. So this is how we're gonna do this. We're just gonna cook some shallots, and this is some chorizo sausage.
Yes.
Okay. Now I want to just while this is just heating up because this doesn't take long.
So wait a second. Are we putting meat with meat?
No, we're putting
yes,
meat with broccoli.
This is a Father's Day dish.
We're pretending to have some vegetables.
Okay, so this is what I want to explain to everyone at home. So this has been pre-blanched.
Yeah.
But if you want to make an even easier vegetable, you take a little bit of olive oil, mm-hmm. A little bit of salt, in the oven for about 20 minutes, out, a little bit of lemon juice, and a little bit of Parmesan, and you're done.
Oh,
okay, so very simple. But what we're doing is
we're calling these dirty onions.
Oh, these are actually, Michael, what you can do is you can put those on the bottom of this plate.
What did you do to those onions?
These are just onions that we've sliced.
Whole thing.
You can use that little tongue because they're going to probably stick to the bottom of the plate. Look at that. Looks like almost.
Who's the expert here, people?
Looks like dessert. Here. Okay, spread it out a bit.
Oh.
So these onions, right? They're beautiful.
What did you do to them?
Ever smell good?
Well, there's a little bit of balsamic in there, a little bit of honey. We put them on a little bit of a roasting rack, and they go underneath. When you're cooking their steak, they go underneath.
Oh, they're so good.
You get all the drippings from the steak in there as well. So that's what the onions are for. And then what we're going to do here,
all right.
Fiona, okay, you got the little bit of the chorizo shallots, a little bit of cream.
A little bit.
Okay, a little bit. And then we're going to go with some Parmesan.
I always love your idea of a little bit.
Well, yeah, a little bit of Parmesan.
This is already the best Father's Day of all.
So let me get this straight.
Cheese.
We've got meat and cheese.
Boom, cheese.
We've got meat and broccoli.
I'm actually salivating.
And onions, and we've got meat and
a little more cream.
It's Father's Day.
This is Father's Day, people.
If this was Mother's Day, it would be a far different
dish. This is the most interactive we've all been.
I know, and some of us are actually paying attention.
See, this is good. It's a beautiful day. It's a great day. It's Father's Day.
It's a great day.
You're a father. I'm a father.
You know what this was? This was a great hockey season.
Yes.
It's so disappointing that it ended on a sour note, but that was an incredible
run by the
team.
And Rob, you're a huge Canucks fan.
I am. So let's not let those.
No.
Ruin us. You know what? Those guys were great.
Because our boys gave us such a fantastic season. They deserve steak.
They're going to have
chorizo.
Yeah, if you want to come, if they want to fly to Winnipeg, they can go come to my place for a barbecue.
Well, they
on
will
Sunday.
Be flying to Winnipeg next year.
Some of them. Okay, what are we doing here?
So this is all we have to do. So we're just right now. Okay. I'm going to take that off your hands.
Out.
You're doing a great job.
Thank you.
Okay.
I just stirred.
We're going to take this. This is the cool part. Okay. Mm. We're just.
So we're putting chorizo on the top of the steamed broccoli, and then we're going to bake this.
Look at that. I'm going to put.
Is that what we're doing?
I'm not. I'm not done yet. Hang on. Okay.
I'm not done yet.
I didn't mean it like
done yet, dude.
Okay, we're gonna take more cheese.
Yay!
It's Father's Day!
Yeah. So great.
Who cares about the calories and cholesterol and all that kind of stuff?
No, I can't feel my left hand, kids. What's wrong?
Okay, so we're gonna,
I don't know, put salt in it.
So this, we do this in the oven for about 20, 25 minutes.
And
325.
Look what it looks
and
like.
Look.
Bada bing, bada boom. Look at that. And then we've got a steak. This is the steak that we put on. This is
the
steak that we put on the grill. Okay, did it obviously in advance.
I gotta get moving
on
this.
Okay, go ahead, come on, let's go.
I forgot.
Okay, show.
Yeah, in, and then what kind of dressing have we got there?
It's a little bit of soy, honey. You got soy, honey, balsamic, a little bit of olive oil. There's some garlic in there as well.
Oops, uh-oh.
That's okay, you've been great. Okay, and then we're gonna take a little bit more fleur de sel.
Sauce of the salad.
Okay.
Doing great, Mikey.
Just like that.
Oh, this is. No salad tossing jokes.
Okay, good, and then just.
Can't wait.
No salad time. You're doing great.
Just like
no, go for it.
What?
You're freaking me out, man.
He cheerleads and then he tells you that you're doing it wrong. It's the best.
No.
So go ahead and do that. No.
Good job. No, don't do that.
Well, you really got the father thing, really.
Okay, look at that. A little bit of olive oil on top.
This guy wants to go.
Okay, look at that. Let's put a little bit of Parmesan cheese powder.
Did we salt it?
There we go. Look at that. So that's a meal. So this is a.
Look at. You know what that says? I love you.
I love you, Daddy.
There you go. It's a
hey, buddy. Happy Father's Day, Phoebe.
And if you want today's recipe, you can email us at urbanrush@shaw.ca. And of course, you can go to Cactus Club. Any of this stuff on the menu yet?
This?
Yeah.
This? No, this is special for us.
This is special for Father's Day.
You can't get this, people. You got to make it yourself. We're going to take a quick break.